Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. This is our second video on Vestel 17PW26-4. In last video, we discussed this input section, bridge rectifier, DC rail, and I removed this IC. Today we will repair this standby section. As I discussed, here is DL321 IC. That is 50 kilohertz switching IC. I will install that IC here. We will recover this section and we will see how it works. Input section, fuse. I jumpered this fuse because its original fuse was burned out. After fuse, PL815. If this plug is not connected, then here are jumpers. In this model where this board is used, in that TV model, here are jumpers. There is no external power switch. After switch, voltage are reaching to this point. Here is a relay point. And the same voltage are reaching to this side. Here is MOV, resistor. After resistor, voltage will reach to NTC. That is surge current protection circuit. Then this inductor, current will reach here. Neutral will reach to this inductor, that is this one. Then current will pass to this path. Then these filters, here is EMI circuit, dual line filter, capacitor, then two inductors, two chokes are here. After that, the voltage will reach here. In last video, I demonstrated how to test bridge rectifier. If you have not watched that video, you can watch it. AC input terminals, then positive voltage will pass through this jumper and it will reach here, then this diode and this positive terminal of the capacitor. Negative terminal is connected directly to capacitor. Positive voltage will reach directly to transformer winding. Negative side is connected to source pin. It will switch this transformer winding and we will receive outputs. IC was damaged. I arranged that IC and now I will install that IC here. DL321. We need this IC. If you will install DH321, that will not work. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair, because here are live voltage. Take care for the safety. Positive voltage from capacitor positive terminal, this one, will reach to this transformer winding. And here are drain pins of this IC. If you see on the diagram, it is IPK FSDL 321 IC806. If this is pin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Pin number 6, 7, 8 are drain pins. 6, 7, 8. These are drain pins. Pin number 1 is ground. This pin, pin number 1, is connected to ground. Through this jumper, that is this one, from this point to this point. And it is connected to capacitor negative terminal. Pin number 1 grounded, it will switch this ground terminal here at pin number 6, 7, 8, and here is transformer winding. Pin number 5 is VSTR, that is high voltage sense resistor. If we check data sheet of DL321 data sheet, this is DL321, DL321 17 watt. The same point we can use DL0165RN. It is the same. Then we will use L0365. It is also 30 watt, but it will work. Here is typical block diagram for flyback application of this IC. Pin number 4 is I peak, peak current setting. In 321 series, we have two numbers, DH321, DL321. And in the same family, we have other numbers, L0165R, M0265, H0265. L number is 50 kHz, either in 321 or 0165. These are 50 kHz. If there is M, that is medium frequency, that is 67 kHz. And if there is H, that is 100 kHz. So we need to take care for the frequency bandwidth. Pin number 3 is feedback. This is feedback pin and it is coming to this optocoupler. And if we check this, this is auxiliary winding. Here is this rectifier. So it will rectify the voltage, that voltage will reach here and it will reach to VCC pin. VCC pin is pin number 2. Here is VCC capacitor and here is its secondary side. Here are two diodes. These are part of RCD snubber. These diodes, these resistors and this capacitor. That is this capacitor. First we will verify the components. This diode, good. This is good. These diodes are good. Good. Let's install this IC. Guide here. Now I will solder it. Now we will apply power and we will check voltage here in the output side. Now we will verify voltage on C892 and C801 as a VCC voltage. Now we will verify voltage on this C801 between these two points. This end is grounded. It will receive rectified VCC voltage, so it will store here. The same voltage will go to this diode, resistor and then VCC capacitor for this IC. So we will check voltage on this capacitor as a VCC voltage of this section. This voltage for complete primary side components. Now I will apply power and I will check it. Yes, the lamp is on. But there is whistling sound, like restarting sound. Fluctuating voltage. Here is also fluctuation. That means this IC is in reboot mode. There is something wrong in the circuit. Now I will check output of this power supply, 3.3 volt and 5 volt. This section 3.3 volt. This winding 3.3 volt and this is common. Common here and rectified voltage here at this point. We will receive 12 volt at this capacitor from 8 to 12 volt from this line, rectified line, this one, this point and this point 5 volt. 5 volt will be stored here. Yes, 3.3 volt section is good. It is 3.4 volt. That's okay. But there is fluctuation on this line. That is this section. We will check voltage on this rectifier. Yes, there is fluctuation. Output of 5 volt regulator is good. That means secondary side has no issue. The fault in this primary side. These two are working as a secondary and this section is also working as a secondary. Auxiliary winding, basically that is also a secondary winding. These voltage are passing to this jumper. It is for PFC section. Yes, it is also stored on this capacitor. Now PFC section is starting. That means there is no issue with PFC. PFC section started because lamp is glowing full. Yes, PFC section is working good. VCC voltage from collector from here, this jumper, then these voltage are reaching to this side. Okay, I will remove this jumper. That voltage are entering to this IC. Because PFC section is starting good, I isolated this section. So I disconnected this jumper now to remove power from this section. We need to isolate that section where is problem. PFC section started. DC voltage. Fantastic. Now we need to check voltage on 5 volt regulator. 5 volt regulator good. Yes, these voltage are stable now. 3.3 volt stable. So fluctuation due to this section. In next video, we will study this PFC section and then we will check what's wrong in this portion. Might be this problem from primary side or maybe problem from secondary side, because this section is fluctuating. That is its main power supply for high power. So this high current power supply is making problem. There are many regulators. If anything is wrong in this portion, that will reflect back to this circuit. Now I will connect this jumper again. Now I will reconnect this jumper. And now we will see the condition again. If the situation returns back, that means the problem in this section I reconnected the jumper and now we will see again. Yes, the fluctuation is back. So, problem in this section. In next section we will study this section and then we will troubleshoot this portion why here is problem. If this video is informative, give a thumb up. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.